Hello and welcome to another lecture where we'll be discussing about COUNTIF. But before that, we will also understand a different type of COUNT functions. Like say, for example, COUNT, COUNTA, and COUNTIF. We will understand these functions one by one, and we'll also understand the difference between them. Okay. So without wasting much time, I'll just share my screen. This is a dummy attendance sheet. Okay, where we'll be trying to understand all the COUNT functions. Okay. Let's just start with COUNT first. To understand COUNT, let's have a couple of numeric data. Say, for example, 2, 5, 6, 8. Okay. I need to count all this data. Let's have some string values as well. A, B, C, D. And then we have L, M, N, O. Okay. We have 1, 3, 5, 7. Right. These are a couple of datas that we have at our end. Let's try and find. Let's try and see the first the COUNT, then COUNTA, and we'll learn COUNTIF over here only. Let's understand all this. Okay. If I apply COUNT function, okay. Let's see what comes. So it is giving me 2, 2, 2, 2, 2. We'll just explain this a bit later. Count A. I need to understand the count A now. I'll go over here and this is giving me 4. Let me just change this D to 8. You see the change? It has become 3. If I change this to 4, it is 7. It becomes 4. If I click on this, if I change this to string value A, G, P, and J, then we have 0. It means COUNT function only counts the number of numbers you have in the data, the integers that you have in the data, right? Let's see if we have 0.5. This also counts the whole number in the data. Let's see if it counts the negative numbers. No, it does not. So it counts the integer. It really counts the negative. I'll just check it right now. Minus 9, minus 10. So it counts the negative numbers as well. So in the range of data, if you want to count the numbers, either positive or negative or the decimal numbers, you'll be using COUNT function. What does COUNT A does? COUNT A counts all of the data into a selected range. So the selected range is 4. So count selected range is 4. So count A has given us 4, right? So count gives us the count of numbers that we have into a selected range, and count A gives us the total selected data that we have. Now what count if is, if you want to count on a particular criteria. Like say, for example, I want to count the present days. So I want to count the present days on a criteria where it is written as P. For present, it is P. For half day, it is HD. For sick leave, it is SL, right? So what I'll do, count if, I'll press in tab, then I'll select the range. You can select this way and that way, that's fine. C3 to N3, what do you need to count? You need to count the P, right? Now you click enter, drag and drop. Okay. So let's check one of them. This says we have present days as 6. Okay, 1 + 5, 6. So the formula works. For half day, what will be doing? I've just dragged the formula like by doing Control R. I need to do a certain change. If I see the range is changing, the range must be C3 to N3 always. So I'll absolute this, okay? What I'll do, I'll absolute this. Fn to Fn F4, now Control R. This is coming as 7. The reason being it is counting P. Now what I need to count? I need to count the HD, okay? And the half days are this. If you want to count the sick leave, just go and change over here, SL, okay? Just will show this one more time. count, count if, range is this. What do you want to count? You want to count the WEE, KOFF, week off, okay, double quotation, and the week offs are counted as well, right? Now, if you need to calculate the total present days, what will be the total present days? Present days plus half days is always 0.5 into how many half days we have taken? One, and I press enter. The total present days are 7.5, 6.5. So these here we have studied how we can calculate, how we can count on the basis of a criteria, how we can count the numbers given in the in a particular range, and how we can count all of the data in a particular range. This is what different count function does. In the next section, we'll be learning SUMIF. Like we want to sum up couple of data on the basis of a criteria. So that will be learned in the next lecture, and after that we'll be learning if error. By the time, please practice all these if functions, and let's meet in the next lecture. Okay, thank you. Have a great day. Bye.